I like the way you work it. No
digging. Hi and welcome to BasinZ.com Gear Guide. Today I'm here to give you a little bit of an overview on servicing, tuning, maintenance of your skis and also your snowboards. Difference between a ski and a snowboard on maintenance? Absolutely none at all, apart from a snowboard tends to be a little bit wider, but then saying that, with a lot of the skis that are used today, some of the skis can be just as wide. So what we've got here is we've got a little bit of a selection of some of the tools that you're going to use, from waxes to P-Tex, the repair candles to scrapers, little irons over here, files, lots and lots of other things. We could talk for hours and hours, but we're going to keep things very, very simple. At the end of the day, maintaining your skis and maintaining your snowboard is going to make your life easier. The board's going to run smoother, the skis are going to run faster as well. Also, edge hold, your IRC conditions, you're in a wall of a half pipe, etc. You've got sharp edges, all that's going to happen is it's going to give you more control. Therefore, you're going to feel more comfortable, you're going to progress more, and at the end of the day, what you need to do is also going to be done. So there's lots of things that you can get. You can start as basic as you want, just from waxing your skis. You can get your files involved. One thing is as well, that what is well worth doing every year is getting your boards and your skis maintained properly by a technician. Servicing and the machines that are used, when people invest hundreds of thousands of dollars into their machines, there's a good reason for it. Some of the things that we have here and doing by hand, you still can't beat by a machine. So what you want to make sure is take a little bit of pride. A little bit of TLC with your own gear goes a long way. Conditioning your hair, cleaning yourself, exactly the same. You don't want things to dry out, you don't want the bases to dry out. So do make sure at the end of the day the maintenance is done. Gonna start with this little one here. This is a base cleaner. This is always a good way to start things off. The idea of this is it just takes the excess wax off, any grease, any other little odors or any type of, let's say ins and outs and dodgy bits actually on the bases, use that. Nice and easy, done. Once you've actually cleaned the base, and also once the base is completely dry, the next stage is actually waxing. There's two different forms of waxing. You have your quick rub-on waxings, just like so. Here's a little rub-on, there's another one, so on and so on. Now these are very easy systems, so all you need to do is get hold of it and physically rub it onto the base of the ski, just like so. Again, sometimes you need to put a little more pressure. The idea of this is it's a very good way to start things off. Now, that's our basic waxing. Once you've got the ins and outs of that, the majority of people tend to go to the next stage, which is something like this. This is a hot waxing, which is where you'll actually tend to use an iron. One of these irons that we've got just here. So, a little bit of extra TLC. Nothing like waxing your own skis or snowboard. It gives you a feel, also keeps you on top of your gear, and you get to know the ins and outs. So this is where you'll need a wax system. Also, in addition to the wax, you'll need a scraper. Why? Because once you've applied the wax, you'll need to scrape the excess wax off. Once that's done, you'll need something like this, a little brush. The idea of the brush is what it does is it polishes things up, makes it shiny, makes it smooth, and at the end of the day, the board, the skis are going to glide nice and smoothly. There's one other thing that could even be used after this, which is one of these little things. It's a cork. And the idea of the cork is it finishes and brings and buffs it up, so again, the skis or the snowboard can glide really smoothly. So you've done your waxing. That's that little bit. You're feeling a little more adventurous. What do you want to do next? Deciding to get into a little bit of edge maintenance. Things like this, files, little deburring blocks, also diamonds as well, separate edging tools. So let's start to break things down. This is a file. This is something that you're going to use in many, many different ways on your ski and snowboard. It's used for detuning. It's used for sharpening your edges. You can also take burrs away. This is something that needs to be in everyone's toolkit, number one side. Another little part is this little deburring block here, which is a rubberized metal. The idea of this is it just takes away little burrs. So instead of using the file on those times where you've only got little bits and pieces, use something like this. Remember, the more you use the file, the more of the life of the edge that you take away. So don't get too happy on the file. The other golden friend is this one. Although it's not golden, it's actually diamond, a little diamond stone. They do these in different colors. Different colors are different coarse. You can have fine, you can have a slightly coarser grade on there. The idea of a diamond file, again, keep it in your pocket. If you do hit little stones, if you do hit little rocks, it's something that what you're going to get is take away those burrs. It's worth its weight in gold. It's great. Again, no need at times to use the extra file system there. Then we can start to get a little more technical. This system here, this is actually an edge angle. Now at the moment we have two different angles on here. We have an 88 degree and also there's 89 degrees and 87 degrees out there on the market. The idea of this is actually the angulation that you have on the base. With a tool like this, you're going to use two other devices. You're going to use the file that we mentioned before, and you're going to use this little clamp device. These three work in harmony. It's something that once you start to maintain your basses a little bit more, you're going to use this. Very good for someone as well that is a little bit unsure or not so confident on tuning their skis. Because of the guide there, it's just a matter of putting onto the side of the edge and running it up and down with the file on there. So it's something at the end of the day, idiot proof, nice and easy. We can then get into a couple of more technical devices. Okay, there's this little beveler here, and again you can use that in different ways, that the file will just slide in that system, and then you've also got this little system as well. There's loads of different tools. This has got a little separate file built into there. Remember, at the end of the day, the more you do, the more you get to know your own gear, you get to understand, and at the end of the day, you're always going to look it after it a little bit more. One other thing that we have here as well, these are PTEX candles, PTEX sticks. The ideas are, if you make little holes in the bases, you take little chunks out, a lot of time you'll use this. Very, very easy to use. Easiest way, if you don't have an iron already, you can just use a lighter. If you are using a lighter, what I'd suggest is when you set fire to it, let the first few drips drip away from the base, because the first few drips are going to have lots and lots of carbon, which is going to be super dirty, and it also doesn't bond too well into the base either. So that's our little PTEX. I just want to talk about this little device here, this little snowboard tool. It's something that every snowboarder should have in their pocket. Also, at the end of the day, a lot of skiers should have, because we have binding systems as well that we may need a little bit of adjustment. It's well worthwhile spending 60 seconds of your time every morning just making sure all of your screws, all of the ratchets are nice and tight before you go out. You do that, that could save you hours and hours of trouble at the end of the day up the hill. That's our basic overview. Again, we love to talk maintenance, we love to talk skis, we love to talk about all of these products. Do remember, at the end of the day, we're here on the phone, we're here at the shop. Something very easy, this is the whole range that we have. Check us out online, check us out in store. This is basenz.com. Good gear online all the time. This is Jace. I like the way you work it. No.